Hi friends, and welcome back to Amanda Muse. So today's little video is gonna be what I am giving my kids in their stocking stuffers. I've got all the things behind me. So we are days away from Christmas, and I'm getting pretty excited. Gotta say that this Christmas has probably been one of the more busy ones in terms of like me professionally with work. Lots of stuff going on, parties, posts, various things. All good. But in terms of actually shopping and getting things done, it has been a breeze. Shopping online is amazing. I find that this year we're doing something different, and I was sort of hinting at it in the vlog. Did you see the vlog? Click up there if you want and then come back and watch this one after. In the vlog, I'd give you a little bit more details about what we're doing for Christmas, but we will be spending it with some extended family, and we're actually going to see people for Christmas, which never happens. Like, this is a first. I tend to go crazy on the stocking stuffers, not sure why. Anyway, it's weird. But I did just hit up the dollar store today, and I picked up some stuff off of Amazon. And I should note, this is not a sponsored post. It's just what I like to order, and I'm pretty sure every mom and their cousin is buying stuff off the internet today. So let's go into what I got. You also may notice a little Christmas tree. Let me tell you a little bit about that. So we should name her. What's her name gonna be? Gladys, that's a good Christmas tree name. We're gonna be spending Christmas in a hotel room. We do have family with extra rooms and things, but we prefer as a family to stay in our own space. It's just a little bit easier when it's all four of us. And also, there's a pool at the hotel, and that's really fun. So anyway, I picked up this little, it was like $4, this little fake Christmas tree, and it has a cute little base, and we're gonna decorate it because Santa needs a place to put the presents, am I right? So let me show you what I got for decorations. These little LED lights. These are multicolored. I'm a multicolored light fan. And I was hoping to find like a little tree topper, and they did, they had one. So tree topper with a couple of little Christmas balls and some, what's this called? Garland. I also found this, and this was $1.50. I mean, it's not like you're breaking the bank. Combination of little Santa's candy canes, red tinted acorns, pine cones, and some Christmas bells. I think they're all in good shape. And you know, the kids just like to have fun decorating it, so they'll help me decorate this in the hotel room. So this wrapping is gonna be Santa's wrapping. So I got four of these, gold with the cream little dots. Do you do that at your house? I like to do, the stockings are from Santa, so I'm just gonna wrap them all of this, put them in their stockings, and then they're gonna have like one gift each from Santa. That's how I do it. That's how we did it as kids, and so I don't know, I've just always done it that way. I do have more wrapping paper downstairs, but you know, you'd rather have more than not enough. So I got these three. We have got, stand by. Good old Peppa. George. And let's see, and then we have Beauty and the Beast. We've got some Belle. And of course, Minions. I do have a combination of some bags downstairs as well, so I'm hoping to make it work. Oh, and then the other thing, I've seen a lot of people on Instagram with these Santa bags. Now, I can't be bothered to spend $20 on a bag. That's not gonna happen. But they had them at, for $3 at Dollar Store. And so this is a giant Santa bag. This is a cute little, what is this guy? Rudolph, fair enough. That price tag works for me, and it does the trick. So there's one, and this will be likely have their Santa presents in it. I'm not sure. Jackie's Santa present is that giant Nerf gun. It is massive. And so did you guys see that video? I'll link it in my suggested toys for kids. So Esme's and Jack's are in there. There's a baby. There's a for real tiger for Esme. Jack has the Nerf gun and a couple other things. Oh, and the PJ masks. He's gonna freak out. So I'm hoping I can do like, you know, I have to figure out the wrapping situation, but we'll make it work. And here's the other bag with Frosty. You can never have too much tape, right? These ones are the transparent, and I also got one invisible. When there's too many options, it confuses me. I'm like, which one should I get? Okay, so let's jump into the stocking stuffers for the kids. The one thing I forgot to show you before to go with the wrapping were these little name tags. I like that they have all the little dogs on it. I thought that was exceptionally cute. All right, so let's jump into what I got them from the dollar store for their stocking stuffers. Play-Doh. So yeah, one for each of them, resealable bag, and it comes with the shape cutout. So it could also be good for playing in the car on the way home. It is Christmas. So I got each of them a little candy cane with chocolates in it. I don't like to go overboard with the candy because quite frankly, neither of them truly eat it, but they both kind of like a little chocolate here and there, and I couldn't resist the cuteness of this like hanging out of their stockings. So chocolate. Both kids are into dinosaurs, and everything I got, I kind of got one of each because I don't want them to fight over it, and also it's just easier to shop like that. So for Jack, I got him a 3D dinosaur puzzle that comes with the fossil that you put together, 3D skeleton, and then Esme got this fossil excavation kit, kind of fun to chip away at this egg and see what's going to be on the inside. Both my little monkeys love to color and their markers are always drying out, so I got Jackie the fat ones and Esme the skinny ones. And because they color so often, we always run out of paper, so I got them each their own coloring pad. Just a white coloring pad, nice thick sturdy paper, perfect for coloring with marker. Santa's a big fan of clean teeth, so I got them each a brand new toothbrush. I figured it'd be kind of fun to have a puzzle, especially if we bring it to Grandma and Grandpa's house. We have something to do on Christmas Day. Not that there wouldn't be other things to do like visit, but you know, while they're cooking and doing all that stuff. So we have a PJ Masks for Jack and a princess one for Esme. And for Jackie, I got the 24 piece. I thought it'd be a little bit better because it's nice and big. And for Esme, I believe this is the 48 piece. And that wraps up the dollar store portion of what I got. That was it. I have here before me my Amazon purchases, so let me show you what I got for the kids. I will jump to the Christmas Eve presents. Christmas Eve, I like to do a book or some pajamas or both, and this year the books came first. I do have some pajamas that I ordered on Amazon. We'll see if they get here on time, I'm not sure. For Esme, I could not be more excited about this book. This is called Goodnight Stories for Rebel Girls. One of you guys suggested it. I'm gonna link everything, by the way, that I got on Amazon in my Amazon shop if you're interested. I'm so pumped about this. First of all, super like feminist pro support and all that stuff, and I can't wait to read it to her and get her inspired about what other women have done in the world. But then also, Jackie, get inspired too. Do you know what I mean? It's all about uplifting men and women. But this book specifically highlights a person. So today is Maria Callas, and she's an opera singer. And it tells you all about her and shows you a bit of a photo of her. Let's see, Maya Angelou, for example, and gives you a whole spiel about it and just a one pager on what that person does. I'm so excited. I feel like this is a gift for me and Esme. For Jack, I also got him a great book. We love some Julia Donaldson in this house. I have not read this one. Jack and the Flum Flum Tree. So I love her writing, by the way. It's so poetic and sing-songy. And I feel like as a Canadian, our voices tend to be rather melodic. Is that the right word? If you listen to my voice, and I get a lot of comments about that, it's very up and down and da-da-da. Like, I don't know. I feel like as Canadians, that's how we talk. So I quite enjoy reading this, and I enjoy reading her books, I should say. So I'm excited. And also, it's got a Jack in it, so awesome. I love me some Melissa and Doug toys. They are huge hits in my house, and stamps of any kind go over well. Last Christmas, if I'm not mistaken, I got each of them a stamp kit, and we've used it ever since, and the ink still works. Not that we use it every day, but still. So for Esme, I got her this one, which is the wooden stamp set alphabet. 56 stamps and 4 color stamp pad. She's getting really into her writing, and she loves writing stories, and I think she'll have a lot of fun making stories with these letters. Uppercase, lowercase. And then for Jack, he likes to do everything his sister does, except he's not quite there for writing. I got hit this one, which is the wooden stamp set, Favorite Things. So it has 26 wooden stamps and the 4 ink and 5 colored pencils. Oh, I didn't even know that. 5 colored pencils up there for all his favorite things. They love to sit at this table and do all of their art. And so you'll notice I got them a lot of stuff just to do more. I am also getting a couple things for my little nephews. So I picked up 2 of these each. I'm not sure who's going to what yet. You fill up the little pen with water and you just go crazy on the paper, and it this is also Melissa and Doug, but it's no mess, no color, so I thought my little ones would like this. I haven't decided who's getting what yet, but then I also got these Melissa and Doug paint with water. You get all of the different colors on the back, and then on the paper itself you can see it has the little paint at the top. You take a little paintbrush with water, dab it in that, and it's enough to paint the whole page. It's pretty awesome. And then also for Esme and Jack, for Melissa and Doug, this is some reusable sticker set. Hers is the, which one is this called? Dress up one. So you can dress up all the characters. And then Jack got the adventure. So he's got 5 scenes, and I gather they tend to mix and match when they play with them. Like he'll play with her dress up one and she'll do this one. But basically you get a blank slate, right? Like that. And then you get the page of stickers and you go to town and you put the stickers on there. So I know you guys, if for longtime viewers, have seen me with these before, because I'm pretty sure I bought these last year too. That's it, guys. Those are my stocking stuffers for the kids and a couple of Christmas Eve presents, and the pajamas haven't arrived. But I will say, for Esme, I got her shorts and a t-shirt because she does not like long winter pajamas, and I managed to find them on Amazon. So I will link everything down below in my Amazon shop, and I wish you all a very Merry Christmas. I will be here on Monday with a little bit of a special Christmas message. So if you have a moment over your spiked eggnog or your spiked coffee, whatever drink you're drinking, come back, check out my Christmas video. And if not, I wish you all a very Merry Christmas, happy holidays to those celebrating, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye, guys.